The Sign of the Times, episode 328. I'm with a very disclosed King Marcus Anderson.
Hello.
And we're at this undisclosed pier. We're at an undisclosed pier. Well, it's been a few weeks. Have you subscribed to Tea Time Magazine?
No, I think I lost the subscription.
How did you lose that?
It's been a busy past couple of weeks.
It's a delightful bubble kiss.
I know. I feel really bad.
There's scone recipes, tea recipes, history of tea.
I know.
You gotta get a subscription. You want it to come to your door.
Mm-hmm. I do.
I mean, like, the cab driver could ferry it over from Japan or something to you. Well, you at least brought my DVD back to me.
Mm-hmm. I did. I enjoyed it.
I didn't think so. It had Casey Carlisle in it. It's one of her best matches of her early portion of her career.
It's the volume one, so.
Yeah, I'm waiting for volume two.
Yeah,
I've been on shows with Casey Carlisle.
I haven't, so I'm very jealous.
Sad state of affairs.
Yeah, it really is. Yeah. We need to fix that.
We do, yeah. Yeah, she's wrestled at PWF before.
Damn.
Yeah, she sure has.
Damn.
Yeah. Wow. Well, you know how we do. We snap and then, look at that. I got a picture of Seymour Snott. Have you got your gouge booking?
No, not yet.
What told you
about? As I said, busy couple of weeks.
You gotta get a hold of the fine people there at Gouge, and after you beg them to bring me back, you see if they got a spot for you.
Boom. Right there. Yeah.
I'm not above begging them. I beg for another shot there. Team Bad Knees, look at that. We're gonna have an important announcement about one of the members right there, Cameron Starr. I'll even just do it right here. We'll break ground.
Oh?
The 2018 Turnbuckle Turmoil Hall of Fame inductee, Cameron Starr.
Very nice. Congratulations.
Yeah, the forearm ninja, if you will. You ever take a forearm from Cameron Starr?
I have not. Pretty gnarly.
I would say so. I think she's knocked a few grown men out. Out cold with the forearm, and she wasn't even throwing her hardest. Yeah.
Well, these days I'll take one. I'm down to party.
If you want to get knocked out, that's fine. The aforementioned Casey Carlisle, look at that.
Very nice.
Large title belt. She's got a bunch of them. Apparently, she was almost detained at the Portland airport with a bag full of large title belts. Luckily, someone recognized her from the Sun of the Times and got her through.
Good.
QT's favorite, the pillow. He loves that pillow. Mm-hmm. Loves it. There she is in smaller form. Insert your own Donnie Idol joke here. You know, Donnie Idol's coming back June 9th. He's been out of the ring since he got attacked at Emerge 9 months ago.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Ugh.
Yeah, he's making his comeback at World's Finest Wrestling. He's going to have a match, I presume, to tune up for Emerge.
Yeah.
You ever wrestle Donnie Idol? I have. If he and Eugene hadn't hit me with like 37 moves and a brick, I would have defeated him.
This stupid brick.
Yeah, Eugene. Wow. You ever fight Eugene?
No, I haven't.
He's a dirty fighter.
I believe it.
Dirty fighter. Well, now you can get that at CaseyCarlisle.com. You go to CaseyCarlisle.com very often.
I need to start going more and more.
You really should. You can get that one unless, you know, you're like Jonathan Wolfe's age, and you probably shouldn't, because he's young. Although I once wrestled him, you know, he was like 14 when I first wrestled Jonathan Wolfe. He'd been in the business for like a year and a half.
Huh.
Better than most of the people that were, you know, around at that point, too.
Yeah.
Look at that. He could get those. Jonathan Wolfe would be fine with that.
Yeah, oh yeah.
Yeah, nothing wrong there. There she is when she went to Hot Nurse University, home of the Fighting Hot Nurses. Mm. Yeah. After graduation.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
Wonderful.
Just like Paul Orndorff. And there she is next to a barn. You ever wrestle in a barn?
I have not.
She has. I confirmed it.
Sounds like a bunch of horseplay to me.
Yeah. I see what you did there.
Hey.
the Twitter where you can follow me, but not literally.
Yeah, that's creepy. Don't like, unless you're like hanging out and having lunch.
Shouldn't do that.
No.
Now, you didn't have the Twitter the last time we spoke. Did you get up to Twitter?
No, I didn't. I did not.
Sad state of affairs.
It really is.
Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, which they may be watching right now. Right, right now, they might be watching it. CAC program.
Wonderful.
CAC was recent.
Mm-hmm.
Stuart Kemp went down there, and things didn't end well for him. He ended up in the hospital, came home, still didn't feel well, ended up in the hospital again, having had a stroke.
Poor dude.
It was an awful, awful time.
Jeez.
Yeah. Yeah. Official Turmoil guest book. You've signed it.
Mm-hmm.
You know who else has?
Casey Carlisle.
No, not yet.
Oh, damn.
Yeah. But a bunch of people have. We got Amber Gertner.
Mm.
Amber Gertner signed it. She was like one of the first. Chico Alvarez.
Very nice.
Yeah. Let's see who else signed it. Randy the Pimp Taylor. You know him.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, Victor I. Price signed it. Paul Cerberus. Have you ever fought Paul Cerberus?
I haven't, no.
Why not?
I've only been up to Washington to wrestle. Actually, I've lost count. It has not been that many times, but I've lost count. Eventually, I want to have a match with him, though, so.
You know, they once wrote of Paul Cerberus in Pro Wrestling Illustrated.
Did they?
They did. It's an actual thing. They really did.
Good deal.
Yeah. Yeah. You're not scared of Paul Cerberus, are you?
Oh, no.
Okay. All right. Well, someone needs to get that match.
Yeah.
We'll call it the Ultimate Dream Match. I don't know whose dream it would be.
I have no idea.
Someone probably wakes up in a cold sweat saying, wow, I really want to see Paul Cerberus versus King Marcus Anderson after they get out of the cab from Japan. Yeah. Well, I'm a busy man this week. You know what we got going on Sunday of this week?
Nothing?
Well, on Turnbuckle Terminal, we actually have Joseph Schwartz.
Ooh.
Yeah, from the Bomb Shelter.
Nice.
Yeah, he's returning to the show.
Good deal.
Monday, it's Memorial Day. I'll probably go to Memorial Day service.
Yeah, that'll be nice.
Yeah. Tuesday, I'll look over some past issues of Teen Time Magazine, which you can get if you ever subscribed.
Yeah, yeah.
Wednesday, I got pretty much nothing. Maybe you could set up your Twitter on Wednesday.
Yeah. Yeah. Potentially, maybe.
So you're around 8:15 in the morning?
I will be sleeping in.
Wow. Are you going to follow Beast Barnett? It might be his only dream in life.
Possibly.
All right. All right. Thursday, I got essentially nothing. On you?
Nothing.
Next Friday, you know who we have on the Sun Guys Wrestling Show? I'll give you a hint. He was a former NWA World's Champion.
He's also, there's a lot of them.
That's where he's also signed this very guest book.
I'm drawing a blank. Who?
Dan Severn.
Ooh.
Dan Severn.
Ooh.
Yeah.
It's going to be great.
Yeah, he's a huge fan of QT's Line of Questioning, which might make him the only person in the history of the world. Potentially.
Potentially.
So to review this from his undisclosed peer.
Yes.
Sunday, we have...
Turnbuckle Turmoil.
With... Joseph Schwartz.
Of the Bomb Shelter.
Yes.
Yes.
You know who he's married to?
I don't.
Randy West, also with the Bomb Shelter.
Mm.
Maker Very of nice. Some fine wrestling gear.
Very nice.
Yeah. Monday.
Memorial Day services.
Yeah. Yeah. Tuesday.
Nothing.
Wednesday.
Nothing.
But you'll be?
I'm potentially setting up Twitter.
Yeah, you could tweet. You could tweet at Dave Meltzer.
I could do that, yeah.
Yeah. Thursday.
That would be nothing as well?
Yeah, pretty much free. Yeah. But next Friday we have...
Dan Severn on Sign Guy's wrestling show.
Yeah. Yeah. Loves QT's Lines of Questioning.
Mm-hmm.
He once did like a 10-minute long question about a bowl of soup at Arizona State University. Dan Severn loved it. Begged us to bring him back after that. Gosh. Begged us. The opposite of Brian Blair, who did not beg us, did not speak to us ever again. Ever.
Sadness.
It really was. Mike McGurk was that close to doing the same. Then she was like, that's fine, I'll go with it. Yeah. You know who else was on with Mike McGurk?
Who?
Lanny Pompfall.
Oh, very nice.
Yeah, he's a genius.
He is a total genius.
Yeah.
Heard he likes to leap.
He really does. But, you know, from the Sun Disclosed Pier, pretty much episode 328.